once again to our today's session. My name is C. Tobejane, and in today's session, we'll be looking at Thevenin's theorem. In our session today, we are going to take one example from the textbook, Macmillan, the Thevenin first book and Troupant publishers, example 1.7. Now, we will attempt to find the currents in a directive or the directed load resistor in the circuit by making use of Thevenin's theorem. If you recall on our previous session, we used the very same theorem, but on a more simpler circuit. Now, let us dive in into the question. In example 1.7, the question reads as follows. Calculate the current flowing through the 12 ohm resistor, which is R3, in the circuit shown in figure 1.17a by making use of Thevenin's theorem. Now, we said that the first thing that you do when you encounter a question like this is to omit that particular load resistor. And after omitting that load resistor, you must mark your points A and B. Now, after doing that, you must be in a position to identify the flow of currents in this particular instance. Now, if V1 was supplying, the current would flow through the load from point A and leave the load point B. When V2 is supplying, the current will enter the load at point B and leave at point A. Now, park that information for now because we're going to use it on a later stage. Now, with regards to this particular circuit, there's a very huge difference in terms of attempting to answer such questions. Why? Let us assume that you are superpositioning this circuit. Short circuit V1. When you short circuit V2, pardon me, this leaves V1 supplying. But the question is, will there be current present in this part of the circuit? The answer is no. Same applies when, this will also apply when V2 or when V1 is also short circuited. This means that this part of the circuit will also not receive current. So, how do we deal with a situation like this? Very simple. We break the circuit into two. It is clear that when V1 is supplying, only R1 and R2 will be benefiting from the current flowing from that voltage source. Same applies with when V2 is supplying, only R4 and R5 will be benefiting from that source. Therefore, let us then split the circuit into two and mark our point C. If you like, you can then redraw your circuit in this fashion. This being point A, this being point C. This being point B, and this being point C as well. So we're having V2, which is 16 volts, and we're having R5, which is 13 ohms, and we're having R4, which is 7 ohms, we're having R2, which is 10 ohms, and we have R1, which is 6 ohms. This is V1, which is 10 volts. Now, we can name this circuit A and name that circuit B. This is to assist us so that we can be able to separate these two circuits, or just to run away from confusions because we already have A and B in the terminals, we can then name this one X or name it Y. It is totally up to you. You can even choose to name the first one AC, to name the other one BC, entirely okay. Now, the next thing that we do, we may need to calculate the current in each of these two separate circuits. Now, let us calculate the current here when V1 is supplying, the total current, IT. We're also going to be calculating the total current this side, I2. Now, if V1 is producing current, this leaves that 10 and 6 are connected in series. That is because there is no other load connected to this site between A and C, therefore current will not flow to that junction. This means that our RS or our RT will be equal to R1 plus R2 for this case only, which is 6 plus 10, that leaves us with 16 ohms. Same applies here, RT2, while this one is RT1, will be R4 plus R5. This is 7 plus 13. 7 plus 13, and then we get our 20. In this case, then, we'd also need to calculate our total current. We're going to call this I1. This is V1 over RT1. V1 is 10 over 16. This side, we're going to call it I2, which is V2 over RT2. This is going to be 16 over 20. Remember, folks, calculator is very important. Make sure you punch your calculator every time you reset your calculator. I did show you on our previous video on how to reset your calculator. You click shift 9 3 equal to AC. This will enable your calculator to reach its reset mode, and then you can be able to punch in the values that you want to punch in that way. So here it gives us the current as 0.625 amps. And this side, we get our current as 0.8 amps. Now, we have identified the currents through each of these two circuits. We need to calculate the volt drop that occur in terminal AC and terminal BC. Now, according to Ohm's law, if you can look at it in this way, let me just draw circuit X, just so you see. If we draw circuit X like this, and we connect our voltmeter here, this means that the reading of voltmeter will only read the voltage across the 10 ohm resistor, R2. Therefore, for X, VAC will be equal to I times R2, because we've proven that the voltage that we'll be getting across those terminals will be the voltage that will be present across this 2 ohm resistor, or rather the 10 ohm resistor. This will give us 0.625 multiplied by 10. This is I1, remember. So 0.625 multiplied by 10, this should give us 6.25 volts. We again come back to calculate for circuit Y. Circuit Y, it's VBC, which is I2R4. Same thing applies. When you connect a voltmeter here, it will give you readings of a voltage across the 7 ohm resistor, which is 0.8 multiplied by 7. You punch that in your calculator. This should give you 5.6 volts. Using this, we can then now be able to calculate our VAB, which is the voltage present across the two terminals, AB. And the voltage present across those two terminals will be equal to our V Thevenin, right? Now we come back to the arrows that we had identified earlier. We said that when V1 is supplying, the current that will enter the load resistor, it will come in from the A and leave from the B. But when it comes from V2, it will come in from the B and leaves from the A. If you recall in our previous session, we said that if you have a situation where two currents are coming in towards a load resistor from different direction, you must then subtract the voltages. But if they are both coming into the same points towards the load resistor, you add them. In this case, what do? We subtract them. VAC minus VBC. This will give us 6.25 minus 5.6. And, sorry, what do we get here? 0.65 volts as our Thevenin resistance. So now we need to calculate our Thevenin resistance. When we calculate our Thevenin resistance, let us go back to our original circuit. What happens when we need to calculate our Thevenin resistance? It means that both of these voltage supplies will be removed or short-circuited. We don't use a voltage supply to calculate our Thevenin resistance there and there. So what is happening here? R1 and R2 will be in parallel but connected in series to this combination or this parallel combination, R4 and R5. How can we see that? Let us see if we can redraw this circuit in a manner in which people can then understand. I'm going to draw my first terminal, which is A, this terminal here. And then I'm going to take this terminal, put it here in the middle, right there. And then my circuit splits into R2 and R1. They both join at point C. And then split once again into R4 and R5. Then make up B. Can you see that? R2 and R1 are parallel, connected in series with R4 and R5. So RAB will be equal to our R Thevenin, which is R2, R1, R2, R1, R4, R5. This should be multiply, sorry. R4, R5. Let us substitute in our values. R2 would be 10, 6, 10, 6, 7, 13, 7, 13. Now, let us get our Thevenin resistance here. Use your calculator. It's best to always have your scientific calculator handy. This will always assist you. Remember, always try to reset your calculator so that you know that the answers that you are getting it from a fresh-minded calculator. This will always be of assistance. Now, if you can look at the answer there, we have our Thevenin resistance as 8.3 ohms. And then the last step is to draw your Thevenin equivalent circuit diagram, as always, where you have RThev there, you have RThev there, and VThev. We have our points A and B. We bring in our load resistor, which was initially R3, and R3 has the value of 12. Just like that. Therefore, our IR3 will be equal to VThev over RThev plus R3. What is our VThev? 0.65. What is our RThev? 8.3. What is our R3? 12. Then we get the current that flows through there. We punch in our calculators. 0.65 divided by 12 plus 8.3. That should give us 0.0032 amps. If you recall on superpositions theorem, we had done the same circuit, but using superposition, and we obtained an answer to this exact level to be 0.032. Now, when you are attempting to do this question, be mindful of all your steps. What's really nice about this is your industrial electronics and for book TVET first book will come in handy with a student workbook. In the workbook, there are certain guidelines that shows you what you should calculate after what. Therefore, it becomes very easy to help you remember what is it that you should calculate. That's it for me today, folks. Let us hope to meet next time when we are doing other circuitry problems.